Hello friends, now I am going to continue with the topic of colonialism in Africa. Earlier we discussed about colonialism in Europe and in Asia. So Africa before the 15th century ending period in the world was unknown region, because Columbus reached to the American continent. On other side, the Dutch were the first community reached to the Africa in all over the world. First time any community entered that area in South Africa. So as the Columbus brought America in light, same way Dutch people brought Africa in light by their entry in that area. Thereafter, Britishers and French people started to establish their colonies over Cape region and Algeria in North Africa respectively. So I want to explain here one point. When you listen the names of the powerful country and small country of that region, you make the list in your note. That powerful country is Spain, powerful country is England, and they control this region. In that way you make the table, so you can prepare a match the pair from this topic. So again I repeat, Britishers and French established their control in North Africa in the region of Cape and Algeria. Thereafter, large region of Africa became useful region to collect raw materials and selling it ready products in post-industrial revolution period. Now you can ask me, but before that I reply you, post-industrial revolution means actually in 1750 to 1830 is considered as period of the industrial revolution. So after that, post means after that, some changes started to come in the world in field of industries. So that period is called post-industrial revolution, means after the 1830, which changes come in world in the industrial field is called post-industrial revolution period. Raw materials and selling ready products came in market. In that way, European countries started to compete with other countries or the powers for establishing colonies. So here you remember one thing, that as like the Asia, in Africa also became the place of the clashes between European countries to establish their colonies. Right, my friends? One small question now I am explaining about this topic. King Leopold of Belgium established his control over Congo region. This is a one-line question. Will come to you. Another country, England, established its colony in Egypt, East Africa, and South Africa. French established their colony in Tunisia, Morocco, and Western African provinces. So now you understand that step by step. I'm explaining first the name of the power who controlled these small regions. And then I explain the name of these African regions. So you can make the table from it. Okay, let's continue. Germany established their power over East and West Africa. Italy captured the African provinces near the Red Sea region. Spain and Portugal established their power over some regions and provinces of Africa. A conference of the European nations held in the Berlin Sea, when almost the region of the Africa came in hands of different countries of the Europe. They were possibly in clash with each other almost the time. To stop all these things, they decided to gather at one place and find out the solution of it. And they met in Berlin in 1884-85. In that period, this conference helped them to stop the competition in African continent to establish colonies between European countries. Due to that, many African territories were divided and distributed among all European nations who were having control in Africa in this conference. Sometime the Berlin conference may ask for 1 mark or 2 marks. So you can write down that to control different African regions and distribute within all European countries who were controlling different regions of the Africa, to distribute them, they gathered, means European countries gathered in Berlin in 1885, and they distributed the regions, means their area. They decided that this area is of Germany, this area is of America, this area is of England. In that way, they distributed it. This conference is called Berlin Conference. Now, one thing more. Colonial dominance means control of different European nations established over Africa, and Africa became the slave, and the colonies, all regions of the Africa became the colonies for every European country. So here it is naturally seen that Europeans were trying to establish their colonies in African and Asian territories, which lead to their different control over some less developed regions. Here some other incidents also took place in Europe itself. So that Germany earlier was a small province named as Prussia. I have spoken Prussia, not Russia, Prussia. And Italy, which was earlier Great Roman Empire, was divided in small provinces, was also unified, and it was political unification of Germany and Italy respectively. So unified Germany also entered in competition of colonialism, commercialization, and industrialization. So remember that here it became the reason for clash between so many countries. Means the colonialism became the reason for clash in future period for World War, lead to the World War. Understand this. Actually, when one country try to control over other country, different other powers may not like this. So this country tries to disturb the political control of other power. So politically, economically and socially, they start to exploit small powers and create the change in the world. So in that way, this is the changing phenomena, that Germany's entry in the competition of the colonialism was earlier not expected by either England, by either Portugal, either Netherlands or the Spain or the French. Nobody was expecting, but after unification of Germany on one side and Italy on other side, both entered in the competition. It was unexpected by all other powers in the world. So they were trying to understand the entry of Germany and Italy in competition of industrialization, globalization and commercialization. Sometime you can ask me, see, you have already understood about the colonialism. But here the word I have spoken, colonialization, means make the small country as the colony, started to develop such attitude in all superpowers at any time. Commercialization means use the raw material of any region for own commercial activity. It is commercialization. And industrialization means develop everywhere own industries and establish own industries, create the control over others. It is called industrialization. So you can understand very well what I mean to say, that world was moving to the unexpected changes by the competition of colonialization, and it brought all countries closer to each other, maybe in competition, maybe in war, right, my friends? So here I discussed about colonialism completely. Okay, friends.